Windows 10 has officially pissed me off. I've noticed... Ask me anything. Well, yeah, I would if you would actually open. Doesn't want to open. Neither does the start menu. Unless I right-click it, then I get this come up, and there's nothing... Yeah, my apps just aren't there anymore. I don't know what has happened. And there's a thing down there, so I'm actually clicking restore before the last update when that bloody... Because since the last update that I noticed it's been doing that weird shit anyway. As it was Mother's Day today, or still is technically, I went over to Mum's. Gonna grab a bag from here because I has some stuffs. Right. I don't think I downloaded. Actually, the only thing I downloaded might be a few music files, I think. So, yeah, I can soon re-download those. Anyway. Took a trip to the recycle centre and spent £5 more than I wanted to, because not only were the two racing bikes still there, there's the handlebars to the ladies one. Yep, I took my toolbox to Mum's and stripped the ladies one down there and then. So I've just got that old handlebar tape to take off and the light bracket. And they came out really easy. And, in fact, I think what I'm going to do with these ones is to slide them straight into the racing frame I've got here. Anyway, that crank didn't come off the ladies one, but this seat did. Couldn't. So I've got a half decent seat at least. Oh, free spider and running around under there as well. Oh well, it doesn't surprise me. What else have we got? I wanted to get the crank off, but I couldn't. I actually think these are going to be too short. I think I'm going to need longer calipers. I think. Some nice blue outers, which I might actually put on my own racing bike, actually. Another one. Didn't really need it, but I thought I'd take it anyway. Sacks hurt dry yet. In fact, I could clean that up and stick that on eBay. I don't actually need any more racing derailleurs, so dig deep. Got another Sacks hurt cable guide there for the gears. Some pedal reflectors. I kept the pedals were horrible, but the reflectors were still good, so I kept those. And this rally crank. I found in my bits that was tucked up the corner in the workshop. Which I forgot I had. I didn't actually realise I had this. I don't even know where I got it from. Biggles must have given it to me, but it seems in rather good condition for something he'd give away, especially that. It's a rally brand as well, because I can see the bird's head here. See it? See the shape? So I know it's a rally crank. I don't think there's any brand on the calipers. No, it's just got the numbers 730 on it. It's a cat eye reflector. It was a BSA racer, but like I said, the frame was absolutely shot. There was no saving the frame. I bought the gents racer as well. That will, I will be restoring that. Well, I say restoring it. Cleaning it up and getting it rideable. It's got a little bit of rust on the crossbar, but apart from that, it's just covered in green crap where it's sat near a tree or something. So, We'll get that cleaned up. Changed the handlebar because I had a steel handlebar in it that was, emphasis on was, chrome. Most chrome has peeled off now, so. But I do have a steel handlebar at Mum's, and I've got an aluminium one here, so I've got a choice. I think this one's aluminium. I think. Where is that steel? I don't actually know. Either way, I just pull off what I think is what's left of the handlebar tape. I think that's what that is, I'm not sure. And I'll retape it. PVC, electrical tape works. I've even got the gear lever on there, which I might move. Well, actually, I'll see what gear levers I've got. It's only a single speed front crank, so. Pardon me. So yeah, busy day. And on top of that, you're probably thinking, how did I spend an extra £5 on bikes when I only bought two? Well, there was a nice rally. Can't remember the make of it, but it's a rally mountain bike that was down there. Back wheel's knackered. The bearings are gone completely and it's buckled, so I'm just going to change the back wheel. It doesn't match the front one anyway, so it's got a bloody tidy frame. It's a darkish sort of green colour. Actually, I've got some photos. This camera's going to need a charge, so I can charge it up, wait for that to finish restoring itself. I'll charge this, and by that time I should be back on Facebook and I can dig up those photos and I can show you what I've got down. I've got four mountain bikes down the back at Mum's, the racer and a shopper bike, a little folding shopper bike. I don't actually know why I keep that, to be honest. Is it doing anything? We keep getting sort of light snow showers. Right. So, tomorrow I think it's going to be a day of getting some bike sword. I need to get some sword. Oh, pardon me. Some sword and sold. I can't remember if I've got the end cups to a cock crank. I think I have, somewhere. Though I suppose it doesn't really matter so long as they fit the frame. I did manage to salvage one quarter pin as well. It came out rather easy, but as Murphy's Law would have it, I could only get the one out. Maybe I should have took the pedals off. I didn't think of that. Although, having said that, I think I've got a pair. So I may not actually need them. Right. I've still got a bike locked around back, but I've been buggered if I'm going down there. Put it away now. Actually, my sister dropped me off because she had dinner as well, as it's Mother's Day. So we were all over at Mum's, and she was working tonight, and she works in town. That's better, you can actually see me. She dropped me off. Makes sense, really, she's coming this way anyway. You wonder what I'm looking for? I'm looking for my pills. Oh, here they are. Here they are. That reminds me, I've got to go down to the doctor's surgery in the morning and whenever I'm up and order some more glycoside because I have now officially ran out. I'm back to using the one stepdad gave me. That wasn't very nice. It's not the worst tasting pill in the world. In fact, my antidepressants taste the worst. These metformin ones, they're not too bad to leave in your mouth. Neither are my glycosides. My glycosides don't have any flavour, but these poxy things, they are really nasty. Right, so I'm going to turn the camera off, get it charged. Listen to a boy racer going round. Oh. I'm going to take apart that battery charger when this is charged. And quickly before I disappear, I took apart that battery screwdriver, the one that had the really mucky battery contacts. Well, there's the motor. I need to just adjust that light a bit. And what I'll do, I'll turn this around. Ah, that's better. There's the motor, and it is actually, well, it was seized, this motor. It was absolutely seized. And that still doesn't... But it has seized up again overnight. I've left it, and it's seized again. Yeah, so it's one knackered motor. Here's the battery pack. I just watched, kept these because I just wanted to show you. And that's pretty much all that was in it, apart from the gearbox at the end where you put your screwdriver tips in. But there's no protection circuit apart from this diode here. And you can see there's a lot of leakage around the battery, so they're knackered. Apart from the diode, it was just a direct charge from the charger to the batteries. I don't know if... No, I'm pretty certain the original charger didn't have anything in it. I don't know if I've still got it, actually. I might throw it out. I think I did throw it out. But apart from this and the motor, and of course the slide switch, there was absolute stuff all in the screwdriver, so... Right. I'm going to get this battery charged. Oh, okie dokie. Well... I've done absolutely bugger all this evening. Apart from play a bit of GTA. And system restore has fixed the problem with the PC anyway. May not have been the update. I don't know what it was. It just... Oh. It's snowing and it's... Pretty damn white out there, and it wasn't like that a minute ago. Ooh, we have snowfall. I can't see. I do believe it is actually currently snowing. Yay! What do you mean camera panning is too fast? Oh, that's because I'm still zoomed in, probably. Oopsie! There we go. Yay for snow! It's not really anything to get excited about, but when you don't see it very often, it is. And it makes a nice change from frickin' rain. Rain can do one for all I care. Yep. Anyway, I think if I'm going to be doing anything bicycle related tomorrow, it's going to be up here. I don't know how much snow we're going to get. I don't know if that little sprinkle is going to be it, or if we're going to get an inch or two. Not a clue. But either way, I need to get some bikes done, so I'm going to have to do them up here. And I'll just have to take them straight back downstairs when I'm done. I'm going to start with the little kid's bike I've got out front, because that is the easiest. Everything works as far as I know. Then after that I might tackle the mountain bike I've got out there with the stuck seat post. In fact, if I bring that bike up first, I could let the WD-40 soak while I'm working on the kids' one. That would make a bit more sense. Yeah, I'll probably do that. Because by the time I'm done playing around with that kid's bike, it will probably have soaked long enough, I hope. Because I haven't actually shown you those two yet, have I? Because I didn't have the room up here at the time. Okay, I'll drag those up here tomorrow. Oh! I'm sure it's getting whiter every time I look out of this window. But I can't see it doing anything. Stick my head out the actual window in a minute, I think. Right, so. Yeah, where was I? First things first, I'm going to bring that bike I keep calling the turd upstairs. Once I've just cleared this. So I can get the parts off it that I want and pretty much just ditch the rest, because the frame is no good, it's not worth it. March and it's snowing. My head's still trying to get round that. That's Britain for you. I have known it to snow at Easter. I have known it to hail in the middle of summer as well. Oh, I've got itchy eyeball. What do you want to borrow? Eh? You try to tell me it's nearly bedtime, because it is just gone 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm not the only one in the family, oddly enough, that stays up till stupid o'clock in the morning. My sister does, but she works nights anyway, so her sleeping pattern isn't brilliant. Ah, now you can see some white. And on the grass. Yay. Probably all we're going to get, and that'll be gone by the time I wake up. My mum doesn't go to bed till late either. The reason being for her, though, she just likes to sit downstairs for a couple of hours on her own, you know, some time to herself and whatnot. Because I don't know why she does it, but she spends most of the day doing chores, cleaning and cooking. Laptop, cleaning, laptop, cooking, laptop, cleaning, that's all she does. Laundry. I forgot to throw laundry into that as well. Oh, bollocks, speaking of laundry, I forgot to give Mum my laundry basket. Oh well, never mind. I can't believe I've been sat here and I hadn't noticed until I put the camera on and walked to the window. Ah, but then again, I did spend 5 minutes sitting at the computer, so that may have had the downfall of snow while I was sat over here. Pardon me. Well, I suppose, whatever the weather, I should get my ass into gear and get them bikes sorted. It's not a good place to lay in the middle of the floor, you numb nut. Oh, pardon me. Ooh. I'm not looking forward to smelling that because I stink. Right. Oh dear. I don't even think they'll charge themselves. I don't even know what voltage I are. Never seen. No, the ends, what look like the positive ends, have all leaked. Ain't they good? So even if I did manage to clean those contacts up, the charging contacts, it wouldn't have worked. But I had a hope and hell's chance in getting that to work. Oh, my old desk lamp I was using in the lounge. I'm going to use in here when I get this shithole cleaned up. So I can work on PCs here. I've got some cases I need. Oh, well, I want to swap around. I'll use that as a work lamp. I'm going to get a, when I can find one, an LED spot bulb to go in there. So I nicked it for the light in the bedroom. The light above the bed in here is has got the LED, that one on the wall over there. It went. Which one of these days I must remember to actually screw to the wall properly, because it's only held up with one screw at the moment. Right. Yeah, it's not going to be long before I sod off to bed, I don't think. Come on, you rattly old fan. Actually, to be honest, since I used those G-clamps to clamp it to the stool, it doesn't rattle anywhere near like it used to, and doesn't make the bloody racket that it used to either. Shit. Oh yeah, don't matter anyway. Biddles wanted me to put that in Mum's car, but Mum didn't bring me home. So I couldn't. It was my sister that brought me home tonight. First time for a while. Because, well, she don't live at Mum's anymore, so. Good. Oh. I messaged a friend of mine saying I've got a saddle for his bike if he likes it. It's not up here. Is it up here or is it downstairs? No, it is up here, I think. I think it's this one out here. It was. Here, here it is. That's the one. But, I don't know if he's going to like it or not. But I'll bolt it on the bike tomorrow and he can come around at his convenience and sit on it. Oops. And if he doesn't like it, then I'll just find another one. It's no problem. Or he can go and buy one. It's up to him. I'm not fussed either way. But, well, I would like it out of my way. Well, it would be a help if I could get it out of the way, put it that way. I want to get a couple of bikes sorted there on that Twailer. I swear every time I do look out here, it's getting whiter. Whiter and whiter. Well, if we do get snow, I'm going to have to keep the bedroom windows shut. Because in the past, I've had little buggers come past while I've been laying in bed and had the window open, throwing snowballs in the open window. Yes, that's very nice when you're laying in bed and wanting to go to sleep and you get a face full of snowball. So, I keep windows shut because of that. I know some people might moan when kids do that, but come on, they're kids. I don't mean any harm by doing it, do they? It's annoying, granted, but I've got better things I could moan about than some kids throwing snowballs in through open windows. Jesus, I know they call me a bloody whinge bag on the Regenerate group and the Town Council group. Although I don't really post that often on either, but Jesus, I've got a long way to go to be as bad as some of them on those groups. In fact, I keep trying to be as positive as I can when I make a post, but at the moment, the group owner of the Regenerate North Walsham group has set posts to approval only. Just because of all the negative stuff that's been going on lately. Because, well, that's not what the group's about. So, if people can't behave, Mum's bought a couple of items on eBay through my eBay account because I can't use theirs at the minute because I haven't paid the fees yet. But, you know, it's a bit like me. Mine will end up the same way. Maybe it'll hold it off till I next get paid, but either way, it's going to have to wait till I next get paid. So if I do lose eBay, tough shit till I get paid. Oh yes. Now this. Speaking of admining and needing to approve posts, let's get a bit light on the subject, shall we? There we go. I checked one of our groups last night that I admin, and as always, there was posts waiting to be approved. As always, at least one of them is a spam post. And this was a pornographic post. But it wasn't your ordinary porn. It was actually child porn. I couldn't believe it. In all the years I've been an admin on Brava's groups, it's got to be 2 years at least now. It's the first time I've come across such thing. I instantly, you know, my instant reaction was to delete and ban the user from the group. But I'm actually thinking I should have reported that. Not only to Facebook, but to the authorities as well. But it's too late now because I can't remember his name. He'll be in the block list on the group, but I can't remember the user's name for love nor money. But yeah, that's got to be the most disturbing post I've ever seen waiting to be approved. This makes you wonder what the fuck is wrong with people. Why? And it was one of those posts that tricks you into clicking on it. So you go to this site and it will ask you to log in with your Facebook details. And of course, unknowingly, people do that, which then gives that site your password and your username. They can then access your account and post spam through your account. That's how it works. And people are stupid enough to fall for it. Just seen a thing about that Zootopia. Look at this. Not a lot has changed, I think, is what that's generally saying. Top one is from Disney's Robin Hood from 1973. And the bottom one is from Zootopia 2016. Foxes and rabbits. Now, the one thing I like about Disney's animated movies is their attention to detail. Even way back then in 1973, when they were doing everything by hand, when everything was hand-drawn, the attention to detail back then was so damn good. I completely forgot what I was going to say after that, but never mind. That's probably why Disney animated films are probably one of my favourites, because they are done so well. I wonder why I could hear purring down my lug hole. You comfortable up there? That's the Lego shelf. And I'm pretty certain you're not a Lego cat. No. Meep. Meep. Now your dish should be relatively full. I filled it up. Well, that reminds me, we need cat food tomorrow. We need cat food for you. And, well, I could log into eBay now and pay for those things for Mum, but I'll do that in the morning. Just thinking miles away, and I was actually watching my eyes on the screen as well. Don't know why, because I know there's some people out there in the wonderful world of YouTube that looks at the camera lens, which is over this way somewhere, and not the screen, but I seem to look at the screen. Don't know why. Ooh, look at those eyes. Oh, they look creepy when I do that. Look like I'm some sort of lunatic. Right. I need a longer screwdriver to scratch my back, really. Need a proper back scratcher, that would help. The bloody cat's following the screwdriver. Want to fix things? No. Oh dear. Close that one, close that one, I'll close Facebook. In fact, I'll close the browser. and say goodnighty to my friend in a minute. Was. Just a cat moving things around. Just don't move things onto the floor, please. Should go see if it's been snowing anymore. I doubt it, but. No. No change, although I can see fresh footprints as someone's walked through here. At this time in the morning on a Sunday, who the hell would be out of that at this time? Sod that, walking out there freezing my nuts off. I'll be tucked up in bed. Anyway, I'm going to disappear, I think. Just trying to think that there's nothing else I want to mention, but. Yeah, so the next video should be cycle repair related and vlog, because I sort of roll both together. That's how I roll. Right. Don't want to be laying in too late then, do I? Never mind. I didn't see if that person replied. I'll check that. Oh no, sod it, I'll check it in the morning. No rush. Yeah, so I'm going to disappear. I'm just going to. Ooh, sort of a hiccup and a burp together. Just want to antagonise the gangs on GTA 5, the ones that hang around Vespucci Beach, because I've got a fire truck. So I'm gonna see if I can piss them off with the fire truck, with the war jet. I can't be bothered with the online stuff. As I've said before, if I had a private server I could go to, you know, with some friends, and I would, but I am not going to a public server. Anyway, I'm going to bugger off. I'm going to play around on GTA for a little bit longer. And I've got to go to bed, so thanks a lot for watching. I always do that with my eyes. Why? Why do I do that with my eyes every time? Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to like. I might get the thumb in view. To like, comment and subscribe. Many thanks in advance. And I'll talk to you again soon. Bye bye. When I can find the thingy button. Well, there it is. Bye. Hi all. It's Monday morning. Monday, 7th of March, 2016. I've only been awake about half an hour. I do need to pop to Sainsbury's because I haven't got any bread, so I can't have any breakfast. Hello. Message. Yeah, I messaged a friend that I've got a seat for his bike, if he likes it. So I'm just going to reply back any day. Oops. Except Thursday. You want to know when I was free this week, so I just said any day except Thursday. I'm pre-booked. What emails have I got? I might as well do that while I'm waking myself up. I'm going to actually pay for those. No, it doesn't need repainting. Not dropping it any lower than 25 because I know for a fact I can get it. Ouch. Spots on. Anyway, plan of action. I'm going to disappear to Sainsbury's, get my loaf of bread so I can have breakfast. Nemo's been fed. Drag that turd bike up here and always cut my mouth off, don't I? Get that turd bike up here, get that stripped down for all the parts I want stroke need. That's it. Then I was going to start on the kids' bike out front. So, without letting this drag on too much, I'm going to shut the camera off and go get some jobs done. Right, so I've got the other one stripped down. There's the forks and wheel. I just took it out in one lump. So I've now got to turn this one upside down. Attempt for removal of bottom bracket, I hope, so I can get in here to spray WD-40 from this side as well as this side, and I'm hoping after a good soak, I've already done this side, that it will eventually release the seat. I might have to get a pipe wrench or some sort of lever on here though. Which risks breaking this piece off, but I can always put another seat post in if that's the case. But this is the bike I've had sitting out front for a while now. Well, I don't know, what, when did I get this? Was it Friday? No, it was before last Friday. I think it was last Tuesday, actually, nearly a week ago. So I've got the kids one out on the landing ready to come in. But yeah, it doesn't need too much work, does it? Well, if I can get that to fix, or get that to move, I should say. This is another one that I actually like. And why is it? I've got this feeling that just because I like it, that's not going to budge. Where is it? It's a Sabotage DT detonator. I don't know what I've put it like that, but never mind. I don't know if any of the brake cables are stuck. I've not tried them. As far as I can tell, gears are a bit sticky. Right. I suppose I should get on with something. I'll put the camera back on when I bring the kids' bike in here, because that will be very shortly, once I've got that lubricated or soaking in some good old WD-40. I'll probably leave it upside down in the bedroom or something. Yeah, it'll have to be in the bedroom, and then that can be so. I have got my foot pump up here, haven't I? Yes, good. I couldn't remember if it was up here or downstairs. It doesn't matter, I've got a hand pump up here as well, because it's got, as far as I can see, all I've got to do is pump the tyres up on that kid's bike. But yeah, I'll come back when I've got that bike in. Right, this one's good as done. I've just got to oil the chain, which I can do before it gets picked up. It's not a problem. Needs a bit of a clean here and there. There's a little bit of muck on the top there. But, I'm going to take a photo of this. And that can go downstairs. In fact, I'll take that seat downstairs with me and I can put that on the other bike. Then I may, as the sun is out, take that thing back downstairs and initiate some brute force. Ow! I'll trip over a VCR while I'm at it. The crank itself came off without any hassle, but that bottom bracket is stuck on there. Probably would come off with a bit of force. But I can't really do a lot up here because, well, I can't bang around too much. So, yeah, I think what I'll do, I'll take this down. I've got that moved, look. But I'm not actually sure if the whole seat post moved or if it was just this top bit in here. It's hard to tell. But yeah, so I may take this one back downstairs and start beating on it, and I might bring the Silver Fox up and see if I can get the crank off of that and the bottom bracket. Chromo. High 10 approved. See? Was that a chromo frame then? I know it's light. For a mountain bike, that is actually quite light. Obviously, I'll change the handlebar on it if I can get this seat post to free off. I can't do my trick on the bottom, but not unless I take my tools down and have a crack at it downstairs. Could do that, I suppose. But in the meantime, I'm going to get a photo taken of this kid's one. I'll sit that one out back, I think. That'll be safer out there. Less risk of someone trying to steal it. Because there is absolutely nothing wrong with it. Gears work, brakes work. Just needs a bit of a rub in places with some steel wool just to clean it a little bit. Just get some of the muck off, that's all. don't think it'll notice on camera, but that's not the point. They can notice it when they collect it anyway, and if I sell it through eBay, experience tells me that you can get some really, really picky bastards on there. You didn't tell me it had this speck of dirt there. I didn't think a speck of dirt was fucking important. That is just what people can be like on eBay. I did take the bar ends off because, I think the other one. Where is it? I think the other one, yeah, the other one's a hell of a lot worse. That's why I took them off. I was going to leave them on there because, you know, yeah, the inside of them is pretty nice, but the outside, nah, took them off. I'll take the bolts out of them because they're the same bolts that fit these and they're pretty clean, so I'll keep those, but I'll just throw out the rest. You know, the daft thing is I can actually ride this, I can actually sit on it quite comfortably and go for a ride. I'm actually on tippy toe and I'm actually pretty certain this is a 24 inch wheel. I'll double check it. Well, I am pretty certain. Oh, I better just take a measurement. Yeah, no, it's not to my standard, but if a kid's going to be riding this, I know they don't tend to have the sort of finger strength I have, so they work. Brakes work pretty well on this. I might take it just for a little ride up and down the path out back when I take it down. No idea why they dumped that one. Some air in the tyres and they could have actually sold it as it was. But, never mind. And the old little ding in the frame here and there. Oh, that's just dirt. I thought that was a ding in the frame. But that one. No, that's just dirt as well. Okay. I'll give it a nice polish up before it goes. What is it? A Magna Mountain Eagle. Where's my tape measure? Just want to know what the frame size is. Not very large, I know that. We are. I'm going to call that a 17 inch frame. And I am pretty certain that these are 24 inch wheels. Just double check because I don't want to say one thing and then find that my guess was wrong. Oh no, there is 24 by 1.95. I was right. And 24s. So, what I'm going to do is scoot off, take this downstairs. Take it for a ride. Actually, no, I'm going to take a photo of it first on the land and take that down, come back up, get the other bike, take that down with some tools, a pipe wrench for one. Pardon me. And a hammer. And if it doesn't free off, then there ain't a lot I can do about it. I'll just have to break the parts from it and use it on something else, and that'd be another one on the scrap heap. Anyway, I'm going to do that and I'll be back later. Well, I have good news. I took this downstairs, beat on the top of this with a hammer, and out it came. And that is absolutely drenched in WD-40, so I know that definitely worked its way down. What I did I whacked the top of this down first and I saw it move. So I got the pipe wrench on the top here and it spun nice and freely. So I just got the hammer and tapped it out. I did it downstairs though, not up here. I don't know, I think I might end up replacing this because I've sort of squished. I missed and hit the corner and it sort of squished it. I think I'll have a seat post, that'll fit that. That looks like a pretty standard size. Changed the handlebar, I think the... that was a bit louder than I thought it would be. I think the stem might clean up enough. I think as this has got an ideal dropout on the frame, I may end up using this as a trailer bike. I don't think it's going to need a lot. I think by the time I just bolt the crank back on, I figured if the crank came off as easy as it did, and that's an aluminium crank, then they could, the seat post shouldn't take too much getting out. But obviously, I'm in a flat and I've got people below me, I couldn't really, whack a hammer on the top of that up here, so that's not exactly heavy. Rear brake is connected, I've just got to make a little adjustment to that. The front one, I need another noodle because this bit is broken. So, it's had a bit of an oopsie, I think. Not unless I can find an end off a rusty one that I can just pull off and put on in here, because there it is. It's completely broken. I'll have a look at my noodles, see what I can do. Mind you, if I put a rusty one on, it will just match the back one. I can find it. Where is it? There it is. Take that horrible looking thing off. And, it's not a bad bike. Not the best one I've ever had, but it's not a bad one. Like I said, I'll see if I can find another bar for this. I could always just put the original seat post back in, but then I look at this and I just think, ugh. The seat post itself is fine, but that's rusty. There's that white corrosive stuff, look, oxidisation stuff, I think. Is that what they call it, oxidisation? Well, it's horrible and a pain in the backside. Yeah, this actually didn't come with a chain, and that rear derailleur was actually just swinging around. And I was a bit worried that it might have got wrenched off and ruined the thread, but I've bolted it back on, so thread's obviously fine. But may need some lubrication on the cables. All the cables have got the ends on, so I'm presuming nothing has actually been changed there cable-wise. I think they've all got it on. There's the front one. Yeah, even the front one. It's a bit stiff up the top here, but it's going up and coming down. It does feel like it needs a bit of a lubrication somewhere. Ooh. Is it me or is that a bit twisted, that derailleur? Might have to straighten that out. Yeah, it's going to need some oiling on the cables. I may just snip the end off, take the cable off, lubricate it and change any of these outers as necessary. I don't think I need to change the outers, actually. I think it's just been sitting around for a bit. Oh, actually, yeah, I will change this one. That's got the original outers on it. Do you know how I know? No, it hasn't. It's got the original front one on. A little bit of a split there, but that's alright. This is the original thinner, proper brake cable outer. Brake cable outers are thinner than gear cable outers, not brake cables. Gear cable outers are thinner than the brake cable ones. The diameter is smaller because a gear cable is thinner. But what I do, which prevents the risk of the cable seizing, I take off these horrible thin ones and I use brake cable ones on the gear cables. I don't know why they do this. I don't know why they just don't use all the same size at the factory, but never mind. I've got some outers. I've actually got a length of outer somewhere in here, I believe. I had it somewhere up here. Oh, well, I've got a couple on there. No, I haven't, because they're thin. Ah, here it is. I knew I laid it somewhere. So I can replace that top bit, not a problem. Front one, I'll start it again. Got a bit of a dicky shifter there. It doesn't like catching to shift it into third gear. But the trick I've found is to get it to catch, you got to push up and then across. See, it does it to second all right. But then sometimes, oh no, I caught it that time. But sometimes it don't. Okay, front gears seem to be working. Right, I'm going to whack the chain on this, sort seat post out, and put the quick release doofy back in. Eventually, if I'm going to keep this as a spare sort of trailer bike, pardon me, I'm going to change the back wheel because it's a quick release. But I think once I've just got that sorted, which is easy enough, I'll just cut the end off. I've got cable ends somewhere. If not, I know I've got some somewhere because I bought a new packet. They were in this area somewhere. Don't ask me where, I haven't got a clue. I can fucking stay down the back there, no? I'll pull that out later. Right, I'm going to get on with that. I think tires need some airing. Yeah, I can do that. If I do that first, then if they've gone flat by the time I'm done with everything else, then I know they're punctured. If they don't, then I know they're not punctured. Right, so next time I turn this camera on, I'm going to stick it on charge for a little bit just to top the battery up. Yeah, when I next come back, it should be relatively a working bike. If I haven't got a handlebar, I'll just leave that one in for the time being till I come across one. I don't want a straight bar in it, I do want one like this, but I don't think I've got one. And I've got to find handlebar grips. They're cheap enough, that's something that I can wait until I next get paid or something. I don't think I've got anything. I did have them shitty spongy ones that were on those handlebars. And if you're wondering why I don't use those handlebars, it's because one, they're a straight bar, and two, I've already got another job for those. Anyway, I'm going to skedaddle and get things done. Okay, so this one's pretty much sorted, aside from missing a handlebar grip, and I won't know until I take it for a test ride, might need to just drop a bit of oil on the gear cable to get the rear gears to work properly. They've gone up and they've dropped down to second gear fine. I did have to adjust the adjustment screws on the back here because it wouldn't go in the first, but it's functions, front gears function, seat's gone back in. I have coated the seat post in some grease just to prevent it seizing into that frame again. Didn't have another handlebar, not like this one, and I haven't even got a straight one, not that I can see up here. So I just cleaned up the handlebar as best I could for the time being. Front brake's working. So what I'm going to do in a minute, as it has and finally stopped raining, we did get a nice shower just now. I'm going to take this back downstairs. I think I've got an odd grip like this in the box downstairs in the shed, so I'm going to find something I can put on here just so I haven't got a hold of a bare metal bar. I'm going to give you a little tip if you ever go to look at a bicycle. You know, you're planning to buy a new bicycle and you're looking for perhaps a used one or a second-hand one, as we'd call it over here. Don't do what a lot of people do. This is what they do when they come to look at a bike that I'm selling. I'll just look it over, and I'll get the brakes, and I'll do that. And I'll just do that, rock it back and forth with the brakes on. Yeah, the brakes work fine. All fine and dandy. The only thing is, I find that even though brakes work absolutely fine, I'll seem pretty damn sharp when there's no weight on the seat and whatnot, and you know, you're not pootling down the road, so it hasn't got to stop the momentum as well as the weight of you and the bike, which I find a lot of the time when you ride a bike, even though they work stationary when you're just rocking it back and forth like this, may not work as well when you go for a bike ride. So it's always a good idea to test ride the bike, is basically what I'm saying. Just test ride the bike. I have so many people that turn up to collect a bike or to look at a bike, and I'll just literally look at it like this. You know, some might spin the wheels to make sure they're not buckled. They might go through the gears on the spot like this to make sure they shift, or they might just take my word for it if I said they worked. You know, for all they know, I could be a bullshitter and say, yeah, the gears work, they work absolutely fine. But I'm not, because I don't sell a bike unless it's working. But they don't even check bottom bracket bearings half the time. You know, because all you got to do at checking is, I just stood on something sharp in my boot. I thought I'd got that out, but they don't even check bottom bracket. Like that. You know, don't check it for play. They don't check the wheels for play. They just spin them round, yeah, it work. If there's no squeaks or knocks or clanks, and they're usually happy and take the bike away. And I don't know why people do that. There's nothing ever wrong with the bikes I sell. Like I said, I wouldn't sell them otherwise. But it's just the fact that I get so many people that don't look at the bike properly. Because technically, sold as seen. You know, I've had people put in buy it nows or best offers, and I've accepted them, and they'll come around and actually look at the bike. Which isn't a problem, because if they don't want it, I can just relist it. It's not a problem. But I think they might just hit the bar now or whatever to sort of reserve it, if you like, because then no one else can, and that gives them a chance to come out and have a look. But, anyway, enough rambling. I'm going to go and get on with some more bits before it gets too dark. I've got about half an hour or so before it gets too dark to really do anything out there. So, I've got a choice. I've got two bikes here I can do now. I've got the racer build, which would be different because I haven't done one for a while. Or I can fart. Or I can bring the Silver Fox mountain bike up and start on that one. I'll decide that when I'm downstairs, so I'll be back later. Yep, I just picked the camera up as I was sitting at the desk, and it looked like it had charged. I couldn't see the little indicator light flashing, so... Anywho, I have put a disc on this wheel. This is a wheel a friend gave me. It didn't have a disc on it, but I've got a pile of them somewhere in here. I don't know where I put them. I've got a pile of spare discs. Anyway, so I slapped one on there. There is some rub on the disc for some reason, and the same with the back one, so I may have to do a bit of adjusting. Needs a new back tire. Crank and bottom bracket is off. And I was actually going to change the crank, but they've cleaned up nice enough, so I've got to throw those back on. The gears worked as they are, oddly enough. They had a bloody good... the front derailleur went up, but it didn't come back down, but that's nothing to soak in some WD-40 overnight won't fix. Eventually, if I keep it, I will change those. But what I want to do is to spend a couple of pounds on some new bearings, because they weren't completely gone, but they weren't long. Well, it wouldn't have been long before they would have just completely gone. I could have got away with tightening them up, but I took it apart anyway, and it came apart easy enough, so I'll just put brand new ones in, and I'll solve that problem. Oh dear, I've really got wind tonight. Oh. Now, I'm not going to change the tyres or anything yet. I've got a feeling I will end up keeping this one, though, when I'm done playing with it. That brake cable pulls fine. But there's a god-awful squeak, and that disc looks absolutely tiny compared to the front one. It is. That's a smaller disc. It's not often I've come across disc brakes with a smaller rear disc. I think, actually, that's my second time. Anyway, that's the original front wheel that came out of this. And I have got a free wheel screwed on it, but if you look, they changed the axle for a short one so it would actually fit. So I've got to go through my tin of axles and put a longer one in. And once I've done that, once I've put a longer axle in there, I'll have a back wheel for the green rally mountain bike I've got at Mum's, the one with the knackered back wheel. Because the one in that green rally, it's buckled and the bearings are shot, so. And I've, like I said, I've got spare axles, so I'll just throw one in this wheel, take the free wheel off first. That won't be hard because I haven't done it up tight, so. If I really wanted to, I could sit and do it tonight and get the job done, but can't do bottom bracket bearings yet because I haven't got any change. I need like £2 and some odd pence. I can't remember what a pack is now. But they come with a tube of lithium grease, so it's not bad for the money. You get the lithium grease with it. I don't know if it's good grease, but I've always used it because it comes with the pack, so I'll just use what it comes with. I haven't had any problems using it anyway. Don't have to, I've got a pair of grease guns behind me, look. Bottom of one there and one there. And I'm going to have to really sort this poxy chair out. It's starting to piss me off. Well, that is seriously getting bad at rocking. We'll have to see if I can do something with that. Mind you, I can always pick a new one up from a charity shop again. That's where this one come from. And I do see them come in at the recycle centre every now and again, so I may grab another one and might roll this one into the bedroom so I've got a chair in it. That's one reason why I haven't played with the consoles or anything in there, because I don't have a chair in there. I've got that one up there which I use when I'm playing the PC and the PC, the PlayStation, and when I'm playing with Lego, but I'd rather have one that's sort of permanently in the bedroom. If I can. Oh, that racing frame I've got that I want to build up into a racer, I was going to make it a hybrid. So it's actually got one of these handlebars already in it. But as I've changed my mind, that will give me another handlebar. Change that seat post for a chrome one, if I've got one, because I've just realised that's quite a chunky one. But yeah, that came off extremely easy. I was pleasantly surprised. Sometimes when the bottom bracket is wobbling around as it was, you'd have a hell of a fight getting the bottom bracket off. But no, that pretty much undone by hand. I started off with a hammer and screwdriver. I've got the proper tool somewhere, but I couldn't be bothered to find it. I've got the proper tool for the lock ring, but I couldn't be bothered to find it. It's down here somewhere. But, yeah, just tapped it off with a screwdriver, then undone both by hand. Didn't even have to use a wrench or anything to get the cup out. In fact, undoing the lock ring unscrewed the cup, so that was a bonus as well. Right, I've just remembered I've got a video for the Lego channel to upload. Might have a sort out of these tools down here. So this one I may throw in the bedroom tomorrow and bring the racing bike up and see how far I can get with that. I need to get some done, I need to get some sold and out of the way really, and that I've had that racing frame for ages because like I said I was gonna use it or convert it into a hybrid bike, but got the racing parts now, so I can put it back as a racer. Anyway, I need to go and use the toilet. There's a surprise. Not. So I'm going to go do that, and I'll report back later tonight. Well, not done a lot, really. Played some GTA, that's about it. Uploaded a video to the Lego channel. And that's it. I haven't done anything. Far too late now to clang around tinkering with bikes. Want to get this bottom bracket done ASAP. Haven't even got anything even half decent that I could chuck in there. No half decent bearings, I mean. Just pouring myself a Coke. That's what I can do, because I still haven't done it yet. Set my set my air freshener up. Oh, it's all right. I've got an air freshener refill down here if I can get to it. Fucking hurt. It's just down under here. And I can't quite reach it. Oh, I got it. Okay, so I've got to pop the lid off. We should just go in like that. I've got to put the batteries in first. What did I do with them packs of batteries? And two packs. Here we go. I need to park you there for a momento. Get a bit of light on the subject to see what we're doing. So, I've got to put batteries in here. And we need three. Three double A's. Yeah, so done a lot of played some of my solitaire game on Facebook. I've just been messing around on GTA. Oh, what do I have to make these packs so damn awkward to get into? Them. One. Two. Three. no idea if it's going to work. I'll leave it off so it don't go foot in my face. Let go in there. And we'll set it. Yep, I have the green light just flashed. Is there a setting to... No, there isn't. So that just got me straight in the head. It does work, though. Do you know where I'm going to put it? I'm going to put it in the bathroom. It's the best place to put it. Let's turn the light on. Stand it in here. I'm gonna pick it off, pick it up one notch. I see. If I do that, motion detector's on. If I click it down, motion detector is off. There's more light in here than that. I do apologise. There you go, I've got the motion detector off at the minute. Or maybe it's not. Because it's just got me again. Yeah, movement sensor is off. Unless that's just what it does when it's setting up, but I smell like bleeding. I can't remember what that fragrance is now. Oh. Smells nice though. Just not on me. Right. I'll probably get distracted at some point tomorrow because Mum's said she might be coming up town. So, I'm not actually sure what I'm going to get done on this. Well, I'm not going to get a lot done because I haven't got the bearings. It's typical Norfolk accent, that is bearings. It's bearings, boy. Right. The two air fresheners I gave to Mum work as well. She's got one in the toilet and one in the lounge, if I remember correctly. When I was over there, she had one set to every 9 minutes, and that was a bit too much to me. And even Mum eventually said that was too much, so... We put it down to the longest setting, which I think is 36 minutes, which is what I've got that one on in there. But, to me, the toilet, or bathroom, whatever you want to call it, usually ends up being the smelliest place, so... I've stuck it in. I can always move it. I could stick it in here if I want. If I want to freshen up in here. Cool. I squirted once in here, and it lingers. That does linger for a while. That's not a bad thing, though. Not a bad thing. Nothing's been going on Facebook to talk about either. I've just left... Really? I've got a notification? I've only just put that video up. Do I work standing up? Sometimes. Shut up. I wonder if it's possible to copyright myself. Do I work standing up? Sometimes, is the answer to that. Sometimes I sit on the chair. Yeah, it just depends how I feel. I think he's only asking because that video I made, I did standing up at the table rather than sitting. Oh, there's those brake rotors. I was looking. I don't get a pile of spare. One, two, three, four, five in that pile. And I've got a few more dotted about as well. Ooh. I think it's a good job I have got that air freshener going. Yes, when I get onto the racer. Well, I suppose I could make a start while I wait for Mum to turn up. If she turns up, you know, plans might change. I saw them scissors somewhere. Where did I see them? Wig. Found them. Just want to start sort of chopping that shit off. Can't put it on. Let me just stick you there just for 2 seconds. All tied in a knot. I presume this is the old original handlebar tape. Well, I definitely want a racer for myself, and technically I've already got one. I've got a nice rally one, which I don't particularly want to get rid of. But I might not want to sell the others either, because I do like my road bikes. And I'm not a hardcore road bike rider. I don't wear all the Lycra and whatnot. Jesus. I think I'd give people a heart attack around here. Get in there. I do apologise if the camera drifts. I'm sort of looking at this, what I'm doing, more than the camera. Come on. This is the last lump of it to come off. So I can pick the rubbish up later. Have I got it? I got it. Yeah, that handlebar's alright. Some marks there, but I think that's old glue from the look of it and the feels of it, so I'll just clean these up and I can do a cheat. There's some PVC tape, that's my cheat. Or, I don't know, I could go in the new cycle shop in town and see if they've got any handlebar tape, but keeping in mind I could probably get it cheaper on eBay. Possibly, I don't know, I don't know what its prices are, I haven't been in there yet. It's been open about a week. But it's just that dopey light bracket to come off now. Ooh, it's on there quite well. That's the last part, that's in the way. Nope. I'm going to get a pair of pliers or something on there. Right. So they're prepared. Almost. And if I'm lucky, this gear cable will reach. I hope it does. It would if I can get that gear lever mounted on the down tube. Or a gear shifter mounted on the down tube. I did look. It's got a that racer's got one of those bottom brackets in, because I was going to put one of those on the bike. So I've got to rip all that off and put the cotter crank on. And I hope I've got a couple of cotter pins. I know I've got one, at least. I'll probably sell it because I won't need it. I'll keep me blue and white rally, I think. I think that's going to be the better option, but I'll whack as many accessories and things on it as possible. Well, except mudguards, because I don't think I've got any mudguards. I might have buried up in my cupboard up here, but I can't be asked to find those. Shit. Forgot to go and order my pills. Bollocks. I knew I forgot to do something. Maybe when Mum's uptown tomorrow we can swing round that way with the car and I can just run in and place the order. Oh yeah. Gotta clean that Saks Heart derailleur up. I don't think I put a derailleur on it. Might be a rear derailleur already on the bike frame, I can't remember. I know I've got some wheels kicking around somewhere. I've actually got several 700 wheels kicking around. It's just a case of finding them. I think I've got a black, or I'm pretty certain I've got a black front wheel to go with that one as well. And I've got a feeling it's up here in this upstairs cupboard, which means I've got to empty half of it out to find it. But I've got till the weekend to do that, and I'll might sit tomorrow evening and just sort that axle out. That was 10:45. Actually thought that was later than that. Speed is this poxy thing. It's an 18 speed. So the options I've got is either find a 6-speed grip shift to put on there. If I really wanted to, I could have sat and just sorted these brakes out, but I couldn't be bothered with that either. I'd had enough by then. Anyway, I could find a 6-speed grip shift, or I could find 7-speed and put a 7-speed freewheel on there. That's another option. But considering these gears are working as is, then it's highly tempting just to leave the damn things as they are. For now, I'll just sort that bottom bracket out so I can actually go for a ride on it and sort the brakes out, and then I can worry about upgrading, changing gear shifters later. And I wouldn't mind some different brake levers on it as well. If I find a pair, oh well. They can stay on there for the time being. Ooh. Got a good front tire on that wheel, I ain't got to worry about that, it's just that back one I've got to change. That one's got a good tyre on it, but I might as well leave that tyre and tube on there because I know it's not punctured. And I know it's a good tyre, so it's a bit daft taking those out. Mind you, I've got tyre and tube on that wheel there. Under there, I could swap that tyre on that back wheel. But they've held air for a few hours at least. You know, if they were badly punctured, they wouldn't. Well, I know it's not the wheel causing the front brake disc to rub, because that is centre. I've just looked, that is dead centre in there. Because if your wheel is slightly off, that can cause the brake to rub. Same with your V-brakes, that can cause them to rub, because your brake levers will be at a funny angle. I mean, it's working fine. don't think those brake pads are much good. If I have to change the calipers, and I can change the calipers or brake pads, I have got another pair that I can clean up and stab on here if I have to. It's not a problem. Anyway, I'm going to disappear for the night. Don't know, I might go back to GTA, I might not. I might just sit at the PC and listen to some music or something. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.